Het gaat in dit geval om een bevoegdelijk door het bestuur van ABN AMRO Bank met Bank of America gesloten koopovereenkomst. Over de mogelijke uitvoering daarvan mag geen onzekerheid bestaan, mede gelet op de belangen van derden. Zelfs als zou moeten worden aangenomen dat de eisen van behoorlijk ondernemingsbestuur meebrengen dat het bestuur van ABN AMRO Holding de voorgenomen afsplitsing en verkoop van LaSalle aan de algemene vergadering van aandeelhouders had moeten voorleggen, heeft een eventueel verzuim op dit punt geen gevolgen voor de rechtsgeldigheid van de transactie.
Totally. I think that's clear enough. It was a very clear decision.
Of course, I'm disappointed. Everybody knows that this is a major transaction that should be brought to the shareholders' meeting. But there's not enough substance in the Dutch law to uphold the decision of the Enterprise Chamber. So we think Dutch law should be changed, and we think, selling a company for $21 billion in a clear takeover battle is something you shouldn't be able to do.
We are very pleased with this ruling of the Supreme Court, obviously, which is completely in line with what we hoped. And actually, we will now complete the transaction on LaSalle as soon as possible.
The implications of it are not very clear yet. We'll have to wait and see what the parties involved will decide, in particular the shareholders that will have to now pick out the interesting candidate for takeover of ABN AMRO. However, the shareholder representatives, the VEB, have committed rather defeat. They are defeated now by this verdict, and I would say this is almost unbelievable, because here we see now that the legal principles totally outrule economic principles.